This is the Turf Zone Podcast, your central information and news hub, bringing together professionals from turf associations across multiple states to share things to help you in your business. Brought to you in partnership with our friends at the Pennsylvania Turfgrass Council. Now, let's get in the zone.
Welcome to the Turf Zone. In this episode of Pennsylvania Turfgrass, we feature an article titled STMA, CAFMO, and FFA Team Up to Nurture Pennsylvania Turfgrass Careers. The sports field management industry continues to evolve and offer many excellent career opportunities, but more and more often there are not enough qualified personnel to fill open positions. CAFMO leaders have committed to a partnership with the Sports Turf Managers Association and Future Farmers of America to address this gap and attract the next generation of turfgrass students in Pennsylvania. It was a natural next step. As CAFMO President Dan Douglas points out, FFA members are already aware of the impact the green industry has on everyone's lives. Introducing a niche segment of the industry, such as turfgrass science, exposes students to a major they can easily relate to. Awareness and opportunities. STMA Education Manager Kristen Althaus, who is spearheading the FFA Turfgrass Science Program nationwide, estimates that 90% of graduates who earn a degree in turfgrass science will land a job right out of college. However, current enrollment in turfgrass science at colleges and universities does not reflect this high rate of success. In a survey conducted by Golf Course Management Magazine, when 40 schools were asked about turfgrass program enrollment, 70% of them reported lower enrollment compared to 10 years ago. One of the challenges contributed to the labor shortage, according to Althaus, is that high school students are simply unaware of turfgrass science as a career path. STMA is therefore working with FFA to create awareness and opportunities for young people to enter the industry and to make a turfgrass science curriculum available nationally for secondary agriculture programs. Everyone at STMA, the board of directors, the members, is really passionate about this career. They see the long-term benefits of involving these students in the industry, and they want to see it prosper, says Althaus. PSU Senior Extension Educator Jeff Fowler, who recorded several training sessions for the new FFA program in Pennsylvania, agrees enthusiastically. Our goal is to provide educational material that can be useful to high school-age students in Pennsylvania, expose them to a potential new field of study, and perhaps a new career opportunity, he says. Many high school agriculture programs across the nation use the FFA to enhance the leadership and experiential learning portions of their program. Through career and leadership development events, participating FFA members in grades 7 to 12 are challenged to develop critical thinking skills and effective decision-making skills, foster teamwork, and promote communication while recognizing the value of ethical competition and individual achievement. STMA's ultimate goal is to create a turfgrass science career development event at the national FFA level. But first, a turfgrass science CDE must be implemented at state levels. To date, New Jersey, Oklahoma, Virginia, and South Carolina have successfully hosted turfgrass science CDEs in their states, and now the Pennsylvania FFA has approved a turfgrass science CDE for 2021 to take place in May. This inaugural event was originally planned for 2020, but the pandemic forced its cancellation. The 2021 event will take place virtually. Individuals or teams of 3 to 4 students may compete. The event will consist of a general knowledge exam of 100 comprehensive questions on turfgrass science and management, an identification segment on weeds, turfgrass varieties, insects, and biotic and abiotic damage, and an oral presentation of solutions to a sports field management scenario. A team effort. Launching the Turfgrass Science FFA program in Pennsylvania has been, above all, a team effort. STMA provides support with the Turfgrass Science curriculum and the CDE. Penn State University faculty have created tutorials for Pennsylvania teachers on how to effectively teach the curriculum, and CAFMO provides the platform to host this educational content. The curriculum is available for a fee through National STMA CAFMO makes the video tutorials created by Penn State turfgrass scientists available free of charge. CAFMO also provides a valuable network of sports field professionals to support teacher success in the classroom, as well as to prepare students for the contest. CAFMO will play a key role in supporting teachers and students as interest and awareness of our turfgrass science grow throughout Pennsylvania through job opportunities and continuing education opportunities. The CAFMO board has been all in from the beginning, says Althaus, having CAFMO's support for the career development contest, especially when we go back to an in-person event, will be essential to its success. The program benefits from the expertise of some of Penn State University Turfgrass Science's most experienced people. Dr. Peter Landschut, professor of turfgrass science, teaches about turfgrass germination and growth, anatomical features, and how the anatomical features lead to correct identification of turfgrasses. He also provides a lesson on common turfgrass diseases. Dr. Andrew McNitt, professor of soil science, discusses various soil properties that are specific to turfgrass systems, including cultivation and top dressing soil management and drainage. Jeffrey Fowler, senior extension educator, addresses mowing and turfgrass insects. Bradley Jakubowski, instructor in agronomy, addresses turfgrass irrigation. Tanner Delvale, extension educator, addresses turfgrass fertility, aeration and top dressing, thatch, IPM, and weed management. And John Seaman, the Penn State coordinator for the Pennsylvania FFA State Convention and Activities Week, has been very supportive in getting the career development event up and running, according to Althaus. The goals of the FFA Turfgrass Science Curriculum and Career Development Event in the state are threefold: building a solid foundation in the science and practices of turfgrass management, introducing students to the career opportunities available in the industry, and creating a pipeline of qualified individuals for professional positions. As the new FFA program prepares to launch in Pennsylvania, Kristen Althaus is full of praise for the team effort that has made it possible. I know all of these guys have so much on their plates with other responsibilities, and they have taken the time to produce these videos and get on board with this effort. They see the long-term benefit of getting these students involved so that there is a future to this industry. This article is largely based on communications by Kristen Althaus. Don't miss an episode of Pennsylvania Turfgrass. Subscribe at Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts. You can also visit us at theturfzone.com.
You've been listening to The Turf Zone. For more episodes of The Turf Zone, visit theturfzone.com and subscribe on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, or your favorite podcast app.